In this class, we will discuss procedures of collective bargaining or stages in the process of collective bargaining. First, we will discuss the meaning of collective bargaining. Collective bargaining is a method of jointly determining working conditions between one or more employers on one side and organized employees on the other. It's a method of solving problems related to wages and working conditions peacefully and voluntarily by the joint efforts of both labor and management. It is opposed to individual bargaining. Let us discuss the procedures of collective bargaining or the stages in the process of collective bargaining. We know that collective bargaining is not the same in all countries. Different countries adopt different type of collective bargaining process. So procedures will be different. For example, the procedure of collective bargaining in a capitalist country will be different from that of a socialist country. And we know that in capitalist countries, normally collective bargaining becomes very essential because laborers are likely to be exploited at the hands of the employers in capitalist countries. But in socialist countries, laborers are generally protected by the state itself. So therefore, the necessity of socialist collective bargaining doesn't arise in socialist countries always, but it is very essential in capitalist countries. Therefore, here we will discuss the working of collective bargaining in capitalist countries. The following are the main stages or procedures in the working of collective bargaining. First stage, submission of charter of demands. So workers first submit their demands in writing to the management. When unions put their demands in writing and put their stamp on the paper of demands, it becomes a legal document and it is called a charter of demands. So charter of demand is a document written by representatives of the employees showing their demands to be presented to the management of a company. Stage number two, preliminary stage or introductory stage. This is a stage where workers or unions are called for the discussion of their problems with the management. This is known as the introductory stage in collective bargaining. Exploratory stage, that's the stage number three. So in this stage, demands are discussed. Workers will try to justify the demands. They will say that their demands are very genuine demands, so they must get it accepted by the management. But on the other hand, management will try to contain some of the demands. They will say that they are not legitimate demands. These are not legitimate demands. These cannot be accepted. All these demands cannot be accepted. So managers will take a different position and workers will take an opposite position. So at this stage, confrontations may start if both parties stick to their stance. Stage number four, reconciliation or persuasion. This is a very crucial stage in collective bargaining because this stage actually decides the success of this collective bargaining. If collective bargaining succeeds, what does it mean? The demands of the employees are accepted. And if collective bargaining fails, the demands are not accepted, so the trade unions will go for a strike. And stage number four, suppose that collective bargaining has succeeded. It does mean that there is an agreement between the employer and the employee. So this is the final stage in collective bargaining. Signing of agreement. At this stage, a written document is prepared and signed by both parties, which is called a collective agreement. And this collective agreement becomes a legal document in countries where statutory collective bargaining exists. And keep in mind the fact that some countries have a statutory collective bargaining process, whereas some other countries do not have statutory collective bargaining. Then the signing of this collective bargaining is very important because of three reasons. One is that in collective bargaining, there will be a peace clause agreed upon by these two parties, employees and the employers. So they will agree to the fact that the peace will be prevailed in the company. There won't be any strike or there won't be any destruction of activities in the company. So such kind of a peace clause will be there. Second thing, period of collective agreement. So this agreement will be valid for a particular period of time. But some agreements are not prescribed for a period of time. So So agreements which have a time period is called a closed ended collective agreement, and agreements which do not have a time period are called open ended collective agreement. And third is arbitration. Arbitration is very important because collective bargaining agreement may have a provision of arbitration. In case of any dispute relating to the interpretation of collective bargaining, then that can be taken to the court or that can be taken for a legal discussion. So therefore, in collective bargaining, the arbitration is very important. So because of these three reasons, the signing of the collective agreement is very important. First is there's a peace clause, and second, there's a period for which the agreement becomes valid, and third, there will be an arbitration provision. What are the various strengths in collective bargaining? One is there are different types of collective bargaining, or there are different type of strengths in collective bargaining process. One is usual collective bargaining. So usual collective bargaining takes place between majority union leader and the employer. So there will be two parties. One is majority union leader. There won't be more trade unions. Only one trade union, that is the strong trade union or majority union trade union leader and employer. So if discussion or collective bargaining takes place between these two parties, then it is called a usual collective bargaining. But coalition bargaining is very different. Coalition bargaining takes place between more than one trade union leader on one side and employers on the other side. So many trade union leaders will be there on one side and many employers will be there on the other side. So this kind of a bargaining is known as collective bargaining. Then the third one is very important, that's patent bargaining. Why is this patent bargaining? Because we know that all firms in an industry may not be making profits. Some firms may be making profit, whereas some other firms are loss-making units. So what generally happens is that the trade unions will pressurize the employers or the owners of the profit-making institutions for an agreement. So they will raise their demands first in the profit-making institutions. Once their demands are met by the profit-making institutions, then the employees in the loss-making institutions will start raising the same demands. This kind of a bargaining is known as patent bargaining. So under this, bargaining is first done in the profit-making institution or organization or company. Then this will be followed. That same pattern will be followed in loss-making or other organizations. Then productivity bargaining. What is productivity bargaining? Under this, bargaining power is tied with the increase in the productivity of laborers. So the employers or the owners or the capitalists, they will say that if there is an increase in the productivity of the employees, then we will give you more and more wage. We will give you more and more compensations in the form of free food or free traveling facilities, whatever it may be. But compensation or more wage will be tied into increasing the productivity of the laborers. So there will be an agreement in the collective agreement document, there will be an agreement that the increase in salary or compensation will be effected only if the laborers show an improvement in their productivity. That's productivity bargaining. Then what is concession bargaining? In concession bargaining, bargaining takes place on the withdrawal of concessions or privileges which the workers already enjoy. So first, means if the privileges or the benefits of the workers are withdrawn by the employers or the firm owners, then these employees will start for the reinstation of the same kind of demand. So such kind of bargaining is known as concession bargaining. So under this, bargaining takes place on the withdrawal of concessions or privileges which the workers enjoy. And it took place in United States of America, Europe, when Japanese firms started capturing such markets, United States and Europe, because then to copy the market by minimizing the cost, trade unions had to surrender some of the privileges which they were enjoying in those days. So trade unions in those days, they prepared themselves to surrender some of the privileges because of the competitions from the Japanese firms. So it was an attempt to minimize the cost. So this kind of bargaining is known as concession bargaining. So bargaining takes place in the withdrawal of concessions or privileges which the workers already enjoy is known as concession bargaining.